Welcome to your half-term 10-minute workout. Now we're going to do all of the exercises today in standing. So you could either remember them as a whole and do them as a workout to top you up between your classes, or you can remember individual exercises and incorporate them throughout the day as you're going about your day-to-day. Okay, so let's get onto our mats. I want you to find a block, so that could be a small step, it could be some large textbooks, or you could do this at the bottom of your stairs. Okay, so come on to standing. So I've got a block here on my mat. I'm going to step my left leg up onto that block to start with. My whole foot is supported onto that block. Now from here, I'm going to make sure I'm bringing my hip in, so I'm getting that lovely alignment, even though I've got an uneven level for my feet. So from here, I'm going to go into my standing scissors. I want you to lift your knee and lower your knee. We're just lightly tapping the foot down towards the floor and then raising back up again. Great, wonderful. As you do this, it's really the supporting leg that's doing the work for you. So I want you to keep an eye on that supporting leg, making sure you're keeping that knee soft, gently pressing through the heel and using your tummy and core to support you. Great, lovely. Keep that movement going there, nice and light. So I want you to keep going in this position. I'm going to turn to the side so you can see what I'm doing in the next part of the exercise. So from here, I want you now to lift that leg up. Then you're going to extend your leg out, fold back in, lower to the floor. Let's do that again. Up, extend, in, and lower. Now if you find as you extend your leg, you're finding that you're struggling with your back, so you might bring your leg out, you might find your back round, just bring your leg slightly lower down. So you're just lightening off and pointing down towards your mat. That's it. Great. So hopefully by now the supporting leg is really working. You're feeling all those stabilizing muscles kicking in and firing. Keep lifting up out of your hip. Lovely. Last two here. Fantastic. And lower back down. Okay, step off your block. Give that leg a little bit of a shake. Let it loosen off. Okay. We're going to come back into that left-hand side. This time we're going to go to our one-leg circle. So standing onto your block, keeping your hips facing forward, I want you to draw a line forward of your foot, draw a little semicircle round behind you, and then come through. Because you're raised up onto the block, you should be able to move your leg freely around. If you find your foot is catching, you can do this with a flex foot coming through your heel. Again, thinking about the supporting leg, lift out this hip, soften your knee, keep your weight even between the big toe and the little toe. This way you'll be really engaging those muscles, challenging the endurance of them. Lovely. Great, wonderful. So yeah, again, I'm going to turn to the side so you can see what I'm doing. I want you to carry on as you are. So, sweeping forward, coming round. As we go round, mind that you don't lose that back position. Keep that tailbone tucked under. So, you can sweep round with your pointed toe. Or if you need to, flex the foot, sweeping round. Lovely, great. Three more here. Focus now on the front of your hips, keep them shining forwards. Try not to let them lift up or down as you move. Last one there. Great, wonderful. Okay, so hopefully that leg is really talking to you now. We're going to go over onto the other side, so you're going to bring your right foot up on the block, and we're going into standing scissors. So, nice length through your body here. When you're ready, lifting and lowering that foot down to the floor. Just coming up to about hip height and then softening your foot back down just in front of your block. Great. Okay, so I want you just to lift that knee as high as you feel comfortable to. Hopefully it'll be working you in your tummy and the supporting leg. For some of you, if you are struggling with very tight hip flexors and these feel like they're coming very overactive and tight in this exercise, just lift that foot behind. So kick the foot behind. Like you're trying to tap your heel to your bottom. Lovely. Great. Because in this exercise, what we're really concerned about is that supporting leg. So we're going to keep moving, keep challenging that supporting leg. So either coming forwards, taps. If your hip flexors are really kicking off, you come into hamstring curl behind. Lovely. Last two here. And relax off, stepping off, give that hip a little break. Now, if you want to make this more challenging, don't rest between, just roll these exercises all into one. Let's come back up onto the step. Right foot on, we're going to go into those circles. So move your leg, coming forward, round and through. Forward, round and through. Keep drawing out of this hip so you're nice and tall, knee is soft. Flex flex the foot if you want a little bit more clearance with the leg. And make sure as you're doing this, the ribs are staying in, you've got that lovely length all the way through your spine. Fantastic. Keep going there. Just got a few more to do. Really angling that leg backwards. As you take that leg backwards, engage the tummy muscles to protect your back and keep that neutral position. Make your bottom do the work for you, not your back. Lovely. Last one there. And step off, releasing those legs. So quite an easy one to incorporate through your day. You know, you could be stood once you finish brushing your teeth or waiting for the kettle to boil, just standing on a step. If you don't have a step to hand, just do it with a bent leg. Do exactly all of those exercises with a bent leg or doing the tap behind. Any combination of those will work throughout the day. Okay, I'm going to bring you now into your scooter leg. So we're going to have to control a little bit more of our upper body and challenge our back control. So I'm going to turn sideways so you can see my position. Again, I'm going to take my foot up onto the step. I'm then going to, when I'm in this position, and I'm going to fold from my waist, making sure I'm maintaining my lower back position. Great. From here, I'm lifting, stepping that foot in front. Then I'm drawing a line along the floor of my leg, making that nice long line for the whole length of my body, and then bringing that leg through. Slide back, step through. Slide back, step through. So imagine you're on a scooter, we're going off for a little ride, and I want you to press back through that leg. As you press back, think about these bottom muscles switching on and engaging to support your back. Great. If you want to make this more challenging, you're going to tap forward, reach back. Tap forward, reach back. I just want you to work to a level where you can really control your back position and support that leg. Okay, let's do a few more on this side. Either drawing that line along the floor or going the tap forward, tap back. Keeping your foot off the floor to make it more advanced. Keeping your foot on the floor for that extra support. Last one. And then step off and swap sides. So these hip muscles, these leg muscles, or these balance muscles will be really challenged by this workout. So stepping on, get that foot completely supported onto your step. When you're ready, folding forward, keeping this lovely neutral in your lower back. And again, we're going forward, draw the line back, tap it forward, draw the line back. So we're aiming for this nice, strong, straight line all the way down our body as we reach behind. Press back through your foot. Okay, so from here, if you want to make it more challenging for balance, we tap in front, we dart out behind. We tap in front, lengthen and away behind. So we're not touching the floor. We're keeping that foot an inch or so off the floor the whole time so that we're really challenging for our balance, challenging this core, engaging the back of the hip and the bottom as we stretch out through that leg. Fantastic. Last few, keep that going. Whichever one you're doing, focus on that leg, keeping this engagement in our tummy. Last one there. Let's shake that leg out. Let's step off. Release those hips. We've got one more exercise to do. And from after that, I'll give you a little stretch to release off your hips. So we don't need the block for this time. I'm going to move the block out of the way. Now, for many of these exercises, you are feeling unsteady. So if you're doing it on the steps, you can hold on to a banister. If you're doing them on the kitchen, you can hold on to the kitchen surface. I've got a foam roller here to help with my balance, okay? So, whichever one is helping you, I just want you to have really good control rather than sort of wobbling lots and lots. So this last one here, we're going to do our foot series. This is going to design to, again, keep working the lower body, the hips, and our balance. And what you want to do is start off going into a little squat, coming back into, you're going to sit down. From there, I want you to come back out of it again. So we're just going to break it down to start with. So squat and out. I'll turn the sideways so you can see. We go back into a squat and back up. Lovely, soft, neutral back. Try not to arch your back. Keeping that tummy engaged as we come down. Using that pelvic floor as you come all the way up. So a little tuck in, draw of that pelvic floor to protect. Squatting is a very vulnerable position for our pelvic floor. Okay, so let's get in the next part of that movement. The next part is our heel raise. So we're going to raise up and down. Just peeling your heels away from the floor, softening back down again. Nice, smooth movement. Easing through. Fantastic. As you do this, shoulders and waist all staying in line. Try not to come forwards. Lengthen through. Imagine as you come up, that pelvic floor and core switches on. And that actually helps the physio lift you up and support you. Okay, I'm going to combine it now for a little bit more of a challenge for your balance. Okay, so we're going to squat back. So small squat back. As we squat back, we're going to lift these heels off. Then we're going to straighten the legs and soften down. So we squat, heel raise, lift and lower. Squat, heel raise, lift, lower. Keep that movement going, working through those legs. Try to, as you come up, to make it really smooth and we're not jolting out with our body. We're keeping a lovely soft line through our spine. Using those bottom muscles and tummy muscles to support us. Okay, you're getting nice and comfortable into this exercise now. I'm going to reverse it. I want you to come up, squat down, release the heels. And up, squat down, release, and out. Last few here. Okay, really focusing on keeping the weight between the big toe and the little toe. Try not to let your ankles go in or out, okay? Last one there. Fantastic, relax down. Okay, I'm going to show you a stretch for your hip muscles and then that's you done for half turn. Okay, so coming down onto the floor, you're going to bring your legs out in front. I'm going to bring my leg, my right leg across my left leg. I'm just going to simply hug that knee up towards my opposite shoulder. As I do that, allow my body to turn and rotate to the side to send that stretch right into the hip. I want you to stretch out these hips, stretch out the legs. I want to spend about 20 to 30 seconds doing this stretch. Do that a few times through on each side. I hope you have a great half turn if you're not here in class, and we'll see you next week. Take care. Bye-bye.